lately.
Okay. Sorry!
Now, this guy's face is probably not far off what your face will look like when you find out why he's been billed as one of Australia's most extraordinary liars.
You just told the biggest lie in the world.
Well, his secret's out, and you're about to see it on the big screen.
I had to fake it till I make it!
Osamah Sami not only does an awesome impersonation of Saddam Hussein, he's an Iraqi refugee turned actor, writer, stand-up comedian, and the creator of what's said to be Australia's first ever Muslim rom-com, based on his own mad life of catastrophic lies. It's called Ali's Wedding, starring Osamah as Ali.
At the start, the lie was fine and I was catching the tram, getting to Melbourne Uni. It was all good, made some friends, and I felt like I kind of belonged. I'm sitting in lectures and suddenly you believe your own lie.
Coming to Australia as a refugee from Iraq, Osamah, the son of a Muslim cleric, was raised with the indisputable expectation he'd become a doctor.
You got the top mark?
Guaranteed.
University of Melbourne, here we come.
96.2.
There's no man alive smarter than his father.
I got 96 also. 0.4.
Liar, liar, liar. And the lies just keep coming while Osamah fakes his enrolment at medical school, attending classes for almost a year, and he had everybody fooled.
When these things happen, you don't think about them. One thing leads to another, and there was such immense community pressure, and my father, who...
Well, he was an imam, a very important man in the community.
Very important man in the community, and my hero as well. I felt if I failed, then people would see Dad as failing. It just crushes you, and you feel you can't breathe, and everybody builds you up to be something that inside you know you're not, and that's not the path that you really want to follow.
I guess a lot of people would wonder, why couldn't you just tell your parents and the community the truth?
At the time, I felt it was impossible. If I had said, hey, I got 68.5, they'd go, oh, you're a dickhead. With everything that Dad and Mum had gone through, the war and migrating to here, when parents work so hard to bring you here, all you have to do is open your book a couple of hours a day and study. That is the expectation, that we've got too many taxi drivers, mate. That's the thing with us, you know, as Arabs. You're either a doctor, a lawyer, or a taxi driver.
Yeah, look, and I'm a journalist and you're an actor. We're failures.
That's right. In our parents' eyes, what are we doing?
And it wasn't just the perfect career Osamah's parents expected. They also forced upon him their hand-picked perfect wife.
You know our daughter, Yumna.
Hello.
G'day.
The boy is so eager to marry. It is done.
Now, you were pushed into an arranged marriage.
Oh, yes.
Is arranged marriage still a thing right now in the Muslim community in Australia?
Yeah, it is. It
really?
Is. Yeah, it is. Like, you think of arranged marriages and straight away it's loaded, it's negative, but it's not always. My parents were arranged and they were married for 30 blissful years. They were madly in love and together. It works for some people, it doesn't work for others. But it's about us having the courage to speak up. And at the time that it was happening to me, I obviously lacked that courage until the wedding night when I went, oh no, I don't want to do this, man. And I just bolted.
Osamah's marriage only lasts exactly 1 hour and 40 minutes.
I went into hiding. That's not in the film.
Where'd you go?
So, you know how on the wedding you get packets with money in them?
Yeah.
And I was like...
You took the money and ran.
Well, it was in my it was in my tuxedo and I thought, what's the protocol here?
He runs away because he wants to be with Diane.
You never told me you were doing medicine.
Didn't know I needed your permission.
His father's left devastated, and there's no way they'd accept her because she's not Muslim and she's not Iraqi.
So do you need a hand carrying this to your father's shop?
It's two bottles.
Osamah's father never got to see the film. He passed away before it was made.
Do you think he forgave you for the lies? Do you feel that he forgave you?
I know he did. And I wish that I could, you know, tell him face to face what he meant. You know, sometimes we don't tell those who we love that we love them until, yeah, You know, but he knows, he feels it.
You've said a couple of times that you hope the film goes some way to dispelling some of the myths or the stereotypes about Muslim communities, particularly in Australia. Well, what are you working to try and change?
We're spoken of, not heard from. There's always an opinion about us, but it's not from us. We belong here and we are part of the Australian narrative. How can we assimilate, as we're always told, if we don't see ourselves reflected?
So what better way to do that than make a Muslim rom-com?
A Muslim rom-com. People laugh, people feel good about themselves. I think Ali's wedding makes you feel good.
Osamah, it's an absolute pleasure to talk to you. Habibi, thank you so much.
Galbita, thank you so much. Thanks.